I think I would have to begin to answer that by saying, because we live in a world doing the things that my organization is doing in Haiti, JPHRO, where we have dependencies and we have great appreciation for a lot of ways in which people contribute. You know, I can say that...
Well, I had the president of Haiti on the show, actually, and he was saying there's a lot of work to be done. I mean, you know, life has moved on for many people around the world, but not for the Haitians. I mean, they are still living in abject poverty, real despair for many, many of those people. And there's a lot of work to be done. And the funding issues, you know, are not helping because they're deterring people from giving money.
That's correct. And this is why I wrote a rebuttal that's on the Rolling Stone website now to this thing, because it was about, because you have to be very accurate in how you do it. Haiti now, Haiti can work. All those U.S. troops that we sent down there in the immediate relief, all the money that we spent on that, the fact of being able to show what this country, what the United States really can be in spirit, recognizing that an hour and a half away is the nation of the first major slave revolt. I mean, there should be, I would think that, frankly, the black Americans of note would be paying more attention to giving Haiti the shot that it needs right now, helping it, because we're on the edge. What they have and what needs to be supported now is the president that you talked to, Martelly, because he is a decisive person. Mm. And because, more importantly, that beyond those who were able to get to the polls, it is my on-the-ground perspective throughout the country, not only in Port-au-Prince, that this president has overwhelming support of the people. So if he is supported correctly now, if he is listened to, mm-hmm. and the donors do start releasing the funds, as they are beginning to do, the World Bank and the IDB and so on, and we are seeing the effects of it, and if people do continue to stay interested in Haiti now, then those who might seek to unseat him from within, which has been a long problem in Haiti, and it's about a certain kind of blind corruption, similar to what I was talking about Gaddafi. They'd rather be a big fish in a little pond than a rich fish in a big pond. And they consider it, many consider, you know, the benefit to the people, collateral damage. But that's starting to reverse itself. And also now is the time that the Haitian people, having had this incredible trauma in a life of poverty trauma, of this earthquake, are now ready to be part of that change. So I think this is the most important moment now for people to be understanding what they're contributing to, but contributing, and though there are so many problems in the world, and so many right here in the United States, the vibrations of what will come out of a success in Haiti, out of a renewed sense of how to accomplish humanitarian aid, and ultimately leading to the rebuilding of independence of a country itself and of the people itself right next door, can also be of great profit for this country, because these people will work hard, and if you pay them $5 a day, it's three more than they used to get.